Hey Emma, remember what I taught you about RAM?
You mean the sheep with horns?
No, the computer RAM.
Oh yeah!
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So recently my computers have been kind of slow for me processing 4K video, so I decided to pick up a new laptop, a gaming laptop actually, to do more video editing with. And the reason why I went with a gaming laptop, because of the video card. So I actually picked up this Dell G5 15 inch laptop, and it's a gaming laptop. And the one of the main reasons why I picked it up was because it came with an NVIDIA GX 1660 Ti video card. So that one of the better video cards, especially for this model. I think it's the top one you can actually get with this model. And what that brings, it also gets you Thunderbolt and then 3.1 Gen 2 USB-C. So I kind of needed all that, or I wanted all that. I decided to go with an i5 processor. It's a 10th gen i5. I bought this in July of 2020, and it's the latest generation Intel i5. I was thinking about going i7 or even a Ryzen, but I think it was too expensive. It was like an extra $250, $300 premium over this one. So I decided just to stick with i5. I've been happy with my i5. Main thing I really needed was the video card, and that video card comes with 6 gigabytes of memory already. This one was on a deal. I think it was $842 when I bought it. It didn't come with that great of memory. I think it only came with 8 gigabytes of memory. Actually gonna upgrade it today. I'm gonna have the girls help me with that. And it also came with a 256 SSD, which is not enough for storing 4K. So I decided I'm gonna put in a 1 terabyte storage drive so I can have some room to store videos on here when I need to. I got the 3-cell battery version, which is only 51 watt hours, but I don't really need the battery for this because most of the time this is gonna be docked on monitors. If you get the 4-cell 68 watt hour one, you won't have the room for the SSD. Extra battery space is where this slot would have been for the regular SSD drive. So that's the compromise you get for a bigger battery. After I bought this, a week and a half after I took delivery, they actually went on sale for $774. So I ended up calling them back and they price matched me. There was an extra $50 coupon, but they wouldn't give me the coupon because it was a price match from an old order. On top of that, I got the American Express $120 deal, which added to that. The only thing is I had to pay tax. I think most of the United States with Dell, you have to pay tax because they have some kind of presence in every state. So overall, I think I got a good deal for what it is. As far as the ports go on this, it comes with a Thunderbolt port, just that one USB-C Thunderbolt. It comes with one USB super speed on this side. On this side, I was surprised to find just regular USB 2.0. I mean, it's 2020. Nobody really uses 2.0 anymore, so I don't know why they have 2.0 on this side. And then it's got the SD card reader. I'm hoping it's the fast SD card reader, but I don't know. I didn't really read the specs on the SD card because I know that makes a big difference when you're transferring large 4K files. Over here, you also got DisplayPort. And even though this has Thunderbolt USB-C, you can't charge through here just because this thing requires a massive 240 watt power supply, which is crazy. But it's a gaming laptop. It's really a desktop replacement laptop. That's the reason why it doesn't charge Thunderbolt. So you'll have to have your regular Dell charger plugged in while you also run it through Thunderbolt for display or for your hub. I was planning to do DisplayPort multi-chaining or daisy chaining for my monitors because that's the kind of monitors I have. So we'll get started on the upgrade on the RAM and the SSD now. So to open this up, there's 10 screws on the back of here. So I've got my little helpers over here today that's gonna help me. They're gonna unscrew the cover so we can get inside and change the RAM. You guys ready to help?
Yeah!
So I'm using my trusty precision screwdriver set. This thing's got like every single bit and everything I ever need to take apart any kind of electronics. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go in here and just unscrew it right here, right Emma? So we got all the screws off. These back ones right here, I don't think they pop out, they just kind of stay in.
In order to take this cover off, you gotta actually pop it with a little flat panel popper. I don't have one right now, so I'm just gonna end up using a little card I had. So you just kind of tuck it in between there, kind of, and then just go along the edge. Now that I got everything released, you kind of gently lift it up and look for that ribbon cable right here, back here. So gotta make sure you don't want to disturb this ribbon cable. I'm just gonna end up leaving it and just flapping it over so that way I can work with all this area right here. So getting into it, I just wanna make sure everything's put back kind of out of the way. So this is, looks like the speaker. Just kind of clip it back in because it fell out of place when we were taking the thing off. And yeah, I'm not sure exactly what this ribbon cable is. It kind of goes to this lower spot here. Up here is the hinge. You gotta be careful up here too with the hinge. I know early models of this had some problems with the hinge, but overall, we're in here now. I've got my Samsung QVO. This is their budget line. Their performance line is the EVO. So this thing's only like $100 for 1 terabyte. So it's a good budget hard drive or SSD for these purposes of just storage. I'm not running an OS or anything on it. So, and it looks like it fits right in here somehow. So we'll figure that out in a second. The RAM is under here. This unit can support up to 32 gigabytes of RAM. So I've got that g.skill RAM that I bought. So I think I paid like $115 for this. So I opted for the g.skill because they had the 3000 megahertz version. I believe the 10th generation i5 supports up to 2933, so this is just a little bit over the maximum that it supports, so it's perfect for what I need it for. What it came with was just basically the minimum you need for this processor. It came with 2 4-gigabyte sticks, which with this day and age, I mean, this thing is a PC 2933 or 2933 megahertz, which I don't know who would use a 4 gigabyte with that kind of speed DDR4 these days, but obviously, you know, they still manufacture it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and stick this in here. Make sure it's fully seated in there. You just press down on it and it just clips right in. That's good right there. I'll put these guys away. Maybe I'll use them somewhere else, who knows, but 8 gigabytes, not very useful in 2020, especially DDR4. If you're in the market for DDR4, you're usually up in the 16 to 32 gigabyte range anyways. So as far as this guy goes, I need to find out how exactly I'm gonna connect this and, you know, how, dang, do I need to get my own plug? Crap, I don't see anything where, I mean, physically it fits in here, but I don't see where I can plug it up. There's no ribbon cable, there's no slot, so dang, this sucks. Oh well, I have to do some more research on this. So I did a little bit of research and I found out there's no easy way to upgrade the SSD in here without buying one of Dell's proprietary heatsinks and brackets. And in this particular configuration that I have, even though I have the room to add an SSD, I can't have my SSD with what I have existing now. I believe if you want an SSD, you actually have to have a special adapter that fits up here on the top section where the drive plugs in, and then you need another bracket over here, and then you don't have the two M.2 slots that this one has. So the second M.2 on that setup has a ribbon that goes over to another plug in here. The only way I can upgrade here is if I use the second SSD slot. So the first SSD slot right now is an M2. It's a 2230, so it's a shorter one. And I can fit a 2280 right here on these two spots, you know, there's a screw there and a screw here, and it plugs right in there. Even though the M2 will plug into there, I still need to buy one of these copper heatsink things from Dell to fit it in there and bolt it down. With this laptop being so new, I mean, it's August of 2020 right now. This thing came out maybe a month or 2 months ago, and it's not easy to find that except directly from Dell. I've looked on eBay, on Amazon, I still haven't found it. So when I do find it and I find a deal on an SSD, I'm gonna end up upgrading that slot. So right now I'm just gonna run with 256, store my stuff on my NAS and work through that. As far as that ribbon cable, you gotta be careful when you take it out. It does the blue light underneath the bottom of this case. So you just gotta be careful when you take it apart that it's no easy way to put it back in. Try not to take it out when you're doing this. So at least I got the RAM upgraded on this video, and you know, I'll deal with that SSD later. And then this guy, I'll just have to put it in my desktop or one of my other PCs. So thanks for watching all the way to the end of this video, guys. So you saw that I got that memory all up and running, booted it up. It shows up as 32 gigabytes on this machine, so everything's working good. Now I just gotta find that bracket for the SSD so I can install an M2. I'm probably gonna go like with a 1 terabyte, maybe even a 2 terabyte, depending if I can find a good deal on a 2 terabyte when I end up doing that. But I'm gonna be patient on that one and just wait for a good deal because I need that bracket, and who knows when that's gonna be really available from Dell. That's not gonna cost me an arm and a leg. So anyways, thanks for watching to the end of this video, guys. And if you liked it, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe to the channel. My channel is mostly car content, but sometimes I'll do these technology things with computers and stuff like that. So, you know, most of it is car content anyway. So if you like that kind of stuff or you like the computer stuff, just go ahead and subscribe. Anyways, I'll talk to you guys next time in the next video.